Hello, Wes. This is RetroTK2, and today you'll be installing Visual Studio Community 2017. You'll also learn how to emulate the development environment that we had set up in VS 2015. I won't be discussing the new features of Visual Studio 2017 with you today, Wes, mainly because a lot of these new features seem to be more focused on the web side of development. There's also a ton of pretty cool stuff to do with C# 7, but alas, with Unity, we are stuck with .NET 3.5 and C# 4. Well, at least with the current stable release of Unity anyway. I'm also not going to discuss the differences between community and professional, but please feel free to check out my previous video on this topic. Card should be on your screen now. I also won't be discussing the extensions that I'm installing here, since I've already done this in the first series. The card should be on your screen once again. So let's get started. Open up your web browser of choice, type Visual Studio Community 2017 download in some search engine, and with any luck, it should be the first link. Hover over the Download Visual Studio button and click the Community 2017 element. Once the download is finished, click the .exe and click Yes on the UAC dialog if it pops up. Click Continue. Right, Ace, you'll probably notice a big difference between the 2015 and the 2017 installs. It seems that the Visual Studio team have made the whole IDE a lot more modular. Which I'd say is a pretty good thing, since you can just select the components you'll need for whatever type of development you're doing. In our case, we'll need to select the Game Development with Unity ticket. I also selected the Visual Studio Extension Development ticket as well, but it's not needed for Unity. One ticket you may want is Game Development with C++. This is needed if you're planning on using Visual Studio with Unreal, or even if you just want to make C++ plugins for Unity. But I'll leave all those decisions to you, Ace. You'll also want to have a look at the individual components too. These seem to be a lot more focused than the previous tickets, and as far as I know, the default selections are grand for Unity. But your mileage may vary, Ace. Once you're happy, click Install. The install should be pretty quick this time round, and for me it took about 6 minutes. No 6-hour installs like last time, Ace? Once the install is complete, click the Launch button to open Visual Studio. You'll be greeted with a sign-in dialog box, and this is pretty important since you'll need to create an account in order to continue using Visual Studio after 30 days. I made a whole video on this for the 2015 version, but the process should be very similar. The card for it is on your screen now. For me, I've already got a Microsoft account, so I'm happy to click Sign In and get the show on the road. Type your email into the text field. And I'd say type your password in too, but for whatever reason, Visual Studio automatically redirects you to another dialog. This process is not a quick one either, Ace, since it takes about a minute for it to get to the next screen. I don't know if this depends on your internet connection or computer's performance, so your times may possibly vary here. After all that, we come to a password entry screen. I really don't understand why Microsoft did this, but I'm sure they had a good reason for it. Anyway, type your password into the text field and click Sign In. After another bit of waiting, a dialog saying "We're getting things ready" should appear. This one should only take about 30 seconds to complete. Once it's complete, Visual Studio should open and greet you with the horrible blue theme. Apologies if you like that theme, yes, I personally can't stand the sight of it. This to me is the most annoying thing about upgrading to a new Visual Studio version. The fact that none of your extensions work anymore and that you have to reinstall everything again. Let's get through this together, Ace. To get ReSharper working with the newest Visual Studio, you'll have to download it from the JetBrains website. I must say I'm gutted here, Ace, since I've been using the older ReSharper 10 with VS 2015. Which is, of course, unsupported with VS 2017. This means I'm going to have to update my subscription after the 30-day trial. Oh well. Once you've downloaded ReSharper, close Visual Studio and click the installers.exe to start the process. When the dialog pops up, make sure the install option is blue beside ReSharper, and you want to make sure the 2017 button is selected. Here I'm deselecting 2015 since I want to continue using ReSharper 10 on that version. I know, yes, let it die, but I just can't let it go. Not just yet. Click the checkbox beside I have read and accept the license agreement and click Install. All standard stuff, yes, very basic. Click Finish once it's all done and you're ready to use ReSharper once again. Let's install the updated Color Picker extension and the Inline Color Picker from Microsoft. Click Tools, Extensions and Updates. Click the Online drop-down button, type Inline Color Picker into the search field, and click the Download beside the Inline Color Picker. After that, click on the color picker element and click the download button beside it. This is the newly updated version of the extension I used in the Inline color picker video, and I was even lucky enough to get a comment from the creator Shamir NS. Apologies if I'm mispronouncing your name. This latest version has many updates according to him, so I look forward to seeing what new tricks it has to offer. While we're here, let's download the Format on Save extension too. Type Format on Save, all one word, into the search field. Here you'll see that this extension is only for ReSharper users, and I must say, yes, it is rather slow when it's reformatting. Still, it's the best one we have for now. If you're feeling adventurous or just don't have ReSharper, you can check out the standard Format on Save extensions. Okay, with all that done, click the Close button and close Visual Studio. This is another big difference with 2017, yes. Once you close Visual Studio after downloading the extensions, it will explicitly ask you if you want to modify your Visual Studio install. I of course want to, so I'm going to click Modify. You may get a dialog saying that the following processes need to finish before continuing. And I'm not going to lie to you, that perfwatson2.exe takes a long time to finish. So feel free to click End Task to force them to end. Click Close and reopen Visual Studio. You can also reinstall ReSpeller if you like. Click ReSharper Extension Manager. ReSpeller Free might be the first extension you see, but in case it isn't, type ReSpeller into the search field. Click the Install button beside it, and then click the Install button at the bottom of the window. ReSharper will now configure Visual Studio, and once it's all done, you'll have to click the Restart Visual Studio to load them text near the top of the window. When the dialog pops up, click Yes to restart Visual Studio, and you should be good to go, Ace. Another thing that might really disappoint you is that the Color Theme extension hasn't been ported over to 2017 yet. Though all is not lost, Ace. If you look in the description, you'll find a link to a hacked version of the 2015 extension that works in Visual Studio 2017. Please be warned here, Ace, you'll be using this software at your own risk, so proceed with caution. Once you get to the download page, click the download dropdown and then click direct download. Once it finishes downloading, click the .exe and when the dialog pops up, click install. Immediately you'll be greeted with a dialog saying the following extensions are not compatible with Visual Studio 2017. Installation may cause Visual Studio to be unstable. Click yes if you dare, yes. Once again, click the end tasks button. And once it's all done, click the Close button. I have to say that even though this extension is a hack, it's been working really well for me. I was even able to export my theme from Visual Studio 2015 and import it straight into 2017. Having said that, it did come up with a dialog saying unexpected error while importing theme, and I did have to restart Visual Studio before the theme switched. But hey, the theme works, and now I have all my wonderfully coloured code. One other thing is, anytime I install a new extension for Visual Studio, my theme will have reverted to the grotesque blue theme and my imported theme will have disappeared. This means that I have to re-import my theme and reselect it each time I install a new extension. But it's a small price to pay to have easy to read code. This has been a survival guide for upgrading to Visual Studio 2017. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, yes. I hope your upgrade has gone smoothly. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com to tell me what you think of Visual Studio 2017. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.